In this video, I will show you how the side scan sonar works, how to correctly interpret the images generated by the device. The main sonar side scan settings, with guidance on how best to adjust them. The most common mistakes to avoid and some useful tricks to improve the quality of reading. The correct method of marking a rock on the map using side scan sonar. To clarify each point, I will use practical examples, graphic images, and screenshots of the tutorial. But before I begin, I invite you to leave a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so, and turn on notifications to stay updated on upcoming videos. Thank you for your support, which helps me grow the channel. Let's take a look at how side scan sonar works, a very different instrument from the traditional echo sounder. Let's start right here. This is the search and discovery area of a traditional echo sounder. The ultrasonic waves emitted by the probe always have a cone shape. Their propagation does not depend on the position of the boat relative to the surface that these waves illuminate. The waves spread through the water in a cone whose amplitude varies depending on the type of probe used. High-frequency probes generate narrow cones, while low-frequency probes produce wider cones. Let us now turn to the sonar side scan reading area. In this case, the area consists of two very narrow blades, one that detects what is to the right of the boat and the other what is to the left. When I speak of very narrow blades, I mean beams with a minimal aperture, even less than one, when viewed from back to front. In the lateral direction, however, these blades are very wide, reaching almost 90. This double blade, oriented to the left and right, detects the bottom and possible targets present. It is precisely the very small thickness of these blades that makes it possible to graphically represent underwater structures with such high realism. To achieve such a reduced thickness, very high frequencies of more than 200 Qs are used. However, this results in reduced maximum range and lower fish detection capability. This type of emission provides a much more accurate and detailed view of the seafloor and marine structures than the conventional echo sounder. In addition, it provides a significantly larger side view, both to the right and left of the boat. Throughout the video, I will explain the advantages and disadvantages of this technology. Now, let's look at how to correctly interpret the images generated by side scan sonar. In the center of the screen, at the top, we find the boat. The two images that develop laterally, to the right and left, represent the detection made by the side scan sonar, thanks to the two side-directed probes integrated in the same transducer. The black part, in the center of the image, corresponds to the water column under the boat, while the two sides represent the seafloor. To understand what the sides represent, we need to do a little mental exercise, as it is not straightforward. Let's start with a visual aid. The bottom starts exactly below the boat. For example, if the seabed is represented 30 meters from the center of the screen, this means that the depth under the boat is 30 meters, a value that is also confirmed by the conventional depth sounder. The water column not only shows fish that are directly under the boat, but also includes those in an imaginary arc that expands laterally. Because the beam of the side scan sonar is very narrow, fish will not appear as arcs, as they do with a traditional echo sounder, but as small bright dots. These dots indicate that a fish is on either side of the boat, but do not provide its precise location. Let us now turn to the bottom and how it is represented. The appearance of the images changes as the depth changes. It is important to remember that the range of the side scan sonar is not directly related to depth. For example, even with a depth of only 10 meters, we can set the range of the instrument to 100 meters per side. If the sonar is sufficiently powerful and well adjusted, it will still be able to detect objects at such distances. As can be seen from the images, at shallower depths, The water column appears narrower, and the representation of the seafloor increases. As a rule, at shallow depths, a maximum range of the instrument is set between 5 and 10 times the depth of the water. At greater depths, greater than 30 to 40 meters, the range is reduced and maintained between 2 and 5 times the depth. Now let's see how a rock is represented on the instrument. If, for example, a rock appears positioned at 40 meters on the screen scale, this distance does not represent its lateral position relative to the boat, but the overall distance between the rock and the transducer. This means that if we mark a point or marker on the sonar side scan, it will not automatically correspond to the precise location of the rock on the chart map. Next, we will see how to correctly perform the operation to mark a rock accurately. Recognizing objects detected by side scan sonar is generally intuitive, as long as the instrument settings, course, and boat speed are correct. Side scan sonar is ideal for detecting isolated rocks, small wrecks, and changes in bottom morphology, which often represent strategic fishing spots. However, it is essential to understand that the objects detected on the screen are not exactly at the distance indicated by the upper scale. In summary, side scan sonar is perfect for searching, but works best with objects that are some distance from the boat. For a more detailed analysis, it is necessary to go over the area identified with a traditional sonar. In this way, more precise information can be obtained to decide whether that spot is a good fishing hotspot. Important things to know to properly use side scan sonar. Boat motion. The boat must be moving to obtain reliable data. It must move forward slowly and at a constant speed. Any change in speed or turn results in loss of information and makes it difficult to interpret the images correctly. Side scan sonar does not work with the boat stationary. Lateral range and sliding speed. As the sonar side scan range increases, screen scrolling slows down, reducing the definition of detected objects. It is important to strike a balance between range and image quality to get the best results. Interference and installation. If your boat has electrical interference, or if the probe is not properly mounted and is affected by air bubbles or turbulence, it will be difficult to achieve optimal results. Correct installation of the electrical system and probe is therefore crucial, as it is for conventional depth sounders as well. On this channel, you will find useful videos for identifying and solving problems related to interference and disturbances. General sonar side scan settings. Gain, sensitivity. Gain can be set manually or automatically. For small depths and small ranges, it is advisable to keep it in automatic. With experience, you can switch to manual to improve viewing of more distant objects by gradually increasing the gain. It is important to try to optimize the resolution at the desired distance, avoiding too high a gain, which could generate noise near the boat or in the water column. Start with a low gain and gradually increase it to the limit of noise. Range. The range does not depend on water depth, but is used to select the maximum range of the sonar side scan. At lower ranges, higher definition is obtained with faster screen scrolling. As the side range is increased, the definition decreases and the scrolling slows down. It is important to keep the scrolling set to a 1:1 ratio, since artificially increasing the scrolling speed does not improve definition. The instrument needs time to read each pulse and receive return echoes, according to the speed of sound in the water. Object size. The size of displayed objects is proportional to the flow rate set. At high flow rates, the same object will appear smaller than at a lower flow rate. Other sonar side scan settings include color palettes, TVG time variable gain, clutter, and scroll speed. If these topics interest you, please let me know by leaving a comment. I will prepare a dedicated in-depth video. Fish vision in sonar side scan. Unlike the traditional fish finder, fish in side scan sonar are not displayed as bows. Instead, you will be able to recognize important targets in the form of small dots, more or less visible, and even schools of forage fish. However, to better evaluate the targets you spot, you will need to go over them with the traditional side scan sonar, which provides a more detailed analysis. Sonar side scan frequencies. Many devices offer a choice of two or more frequencies for side scan sonar. It is important to remember that higher frequencies improve image definition but reduce maximum range. Lower frequencies offer lower resolution but allow greater distances to be covered. We will now analyze a screenshot of a sonar side scan to evaluate all the most important aspects and better understand how to use this tool. We will look together at the correct operations to accurately mark a rock on the cartography. Taking advantage of both side scan sonar and traditional sounder, recognizing objects detected by side scan sonar is generally intuitive as long as the instrument settings, course, and boat speed are correct. Side scan sonar is ideal for finding isolated rocks, small wrecks, and changes in bottom morphology, which often represent strategic fishing spots. However, it is very important to understand that objects detected on side scan sonar are not exactly at the distance indicated on the top scale of the screen. In summary, side scan sonar is a great tool for searching, but it works best when the objects are at a certain distance from the boat. For a more in-depth analysis, you need to go over the area detected with a traditional sonar sounder. This will allow you to gather all the information you need to decide whether a spot is a good fishing hotspot or not. Thank you for watching this video. Remember to subscribe to the channel, where you will find lots of other useful and interesting content to further your knowledge of your onboard instrumentation. Thanks again, and see you in the next video.